House. Hey. My usual, please. Well, I ruined another relationship. I suppose you want to hear the whole sorry tale.
No, thank you.
Last night, Julia came over, and as usual, I made a mess of things. Did you say no?
I said no, thank you.
But I wish to unburden myself.
And I wish to remain in my good mood. Therefore, I demur.
You demur?
I demur. Oh. Besides, I'm sure I've heard it all before.
But this time was different. I really thought she could have been the one. Well, silly me. Think that I could count on my only brother for a shoulder on which to lean.
What you need isn't a shoulder, it's a swift boot to break you out of this pattern.
What pattern?
Your pattern of ruining things before they've even begun.
And when have I done that?
Let me see. Faye, Cassandra, Chelsea, Claire, Lana, Abby, Mia, Marie.
Oh, all right. I knew I had a pattern, I just didn't think you'd remember the names.
The minute you develop feelings for someone, you get scared and find some way to sabotage things.
I'd like to strike you, of course, but you speak the truth. I tell you what, I will never find a happy relationship unless I can break out of this maddening cycle.
Well, all right, all right, all right. The next time you find yourself doing it again, fixating, say, on some tiny fault of the woman, recognize what that is. Mm. You're feeling vulnerable. But don't give in to the fear. Mm-hmm. Commit to commitment.
Commit to commitment. It's a bit glib, but nonetheless inspiring. Thank you, Niles. I'm going to call Julia, and I will not take no for an answer. I may have walked in here the old fault-finding, flaw-fleeing Fraser, but I leave a man committed to commitment.
You said Fraser.
I did not. I most certainly did
no,
not.
I heard you say Fraser.
I've been saying my own name for the last 40-some-odd years.
Like your tongue, you go that way. Never take Fraser.